sat patiently beneath the boughs of an apple tree. She waited there through many a day for her ducklings to be born.
The mama duck was round and soft, and she sat in a warm brown nest. Under her wings were four eggs, three small ones, and the fourth remarkably large. Suddenly, to her delight, the smaller eggs burst. One, two, three. And three charming baby ducks popped their heads out. They looked around them with amazement and said to their mama,
"How wide the world seems.
How high is the sky.
The trees are so green.
Green's good for the eye. You'll find much for wonder.
Beep, 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 beep.
And joys without number.
Beep, 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 beep.
The meadow is endless.
This air is so clear.
The pond is tremendous.
There's nothing to fear. My dears, how nice you're all here. That is all but one. If only this last egg would burst, we could all go in the water. But it's so large."
The mama duck sat and sat, but the egg didn't burst. After a few days, an old duck came to pay her a visit.
"Well, you sure have been on that egg a long time, Mrs. Duck. Must be a turkey. Might as well quit and start teaching your ducklings how to swim."
"I think I'll sit on it just a little longer."
And with that, there came a peculiar quack. And the great egg burst. Out came the biggest, ugliest duckling anyone had ever seen. Oh, how all the ducks laughed at him.
"Perhaps he is a turkey chick. But he'll go in the water even if I have to push him in myself."
Really, though, he swam as well as any of them. And sang as well, too.
"It's lovely to swim, to skim over ripples, to dive for a nibble of bread. It's lovely to slide, to glide on the water, or let it close over your head."
"Look at him go. No, it's certainly not a turkey. He's my own child, even though he's not much to look at. Come, come. I'll present you all in the barnyard now. Follow me, but take care no one steps on you."
The little ducks made themselves right at home in the barnyard. All except the last ugly duck. He was beaten and pushed. The turkey gobbled at him. And the chickens pecked and flapped their wings at him. The other ducks were just as bad. They quacked and turned their backs on him. It got worse every day. The poor duckling was mocked by everyone.
They jeered, they sneered, they said, "You're weird." At last, one day, he flew away. He flew over the barnyard fence. A long, long flight to a moor that was dim and dense. And there he passed the night. It was dark and full of gloom. He shivered beneath his wings, alone and far from home.
In the morning, two wild ducks flew up. They looked at the duckling.
"You're remarkably ugly."
"You sure are. But it's nothing to us, as long as you don't try to marry into our family."
The wild ducks fell dead. A hunt had begun. hunting dogs came rushing into the swamp. Suddenly, a huge, frightful dog stopped right by the duckling, his tongue hanging out of his mouth. He showed his teeth. And then he raced on without even touching the duckling.
Thank goodness!
I'm a terribly ugly duck, and occasionally that's my luck. Not even a dog in this dreadful bog wants to take a bite, 'cause I'm such a sight. So it's plain to see no one wants me, an ugly duck.
Hours later, all was quiet, and the duckling hurried off the moor as fast as he could. He went a long way without meeting anyone, but at last he came to an old hut, so dilapidated it didn't know itself which way it should fall. Cold and frightened, the duckling slipped through a crack into the room. Here there lived a cranky woman with her cat and her hen. They were very proud, but the woman, thinking that the duckling might lay eggs for her just the way the hen did, said he could stay for a while. Then the cat and the hen introduced themselves.
Here's Mr. Cat, who's quite a wit.
And Mistress Hen, on eggs she sits.
We're both so clever and so much better than you. It's true, but if you try to be like us,
and do not cry, and do not fuss, we'll let you stay here. What luck for a duck to be near us. Marvelous!
Indeed, these two thought they were half the world, and much the better half. But when the duckling hinted that this might not be so, they cried,
bark, 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 bark.
Can you lay eggs?
No.
Meow.
Can you arch your back or purr?
No.
Then will you hold your tongue when clever folks are speaking?
Then the duckling sat in a corner. And when he felt the warm sunshine stream in the window, he began to dream aloud.
It's lovely to swim, to skim over ripples, to dive for a nibble of bread.
Why should you dive? Who wants to swim? You certainly have stupid whims.
Just stretch your legs
or lay some eggs like me.
Like me.
Like us. Marvelous.
I think I will go out into the wide world.
Yes, do go.
And so he went away. He swam on the water and dived, but no one said a word to him because he was so ugly. Then one night he heard a peculiar cry and saw above him a flock of great white birds, swans. They mounted so high, so high. The duckling felt a strange longing for them.
Such birds, such birds. I never have seen such beautiful birds. They dip, they soar. I never have seen such beautiful birds before.
But of course, they never noticed him. And now came the winter. It was bitterly cold. The duckling had to swim about constantly to keep part of the water free of ice. But every night the space he swam in became smaller and smaller. And last he was exhausted and lay still and froze fast in the ice. In the morning, a peasant came by. He cracked the ice crust to pieces and carried the duckling home. In the warm room, the duckling came too. But when the peasant's children tried to play with him, the duckling was afraid he would be hurt again and flew wildly around the room. The children tried to catch him.
the milk.
Spilled all the milk.
Upset the bread.
Upset the bread.
Laying out the pillows off the bed.
Off the bed.
The buttertub.
The buttertub.
Crashed to the floor.
Bang to the floor.
Frantic, he fluttered out the door.
Out the door.
Somehow he got through the winter. And when spring came, the duckling tried his wings. They seemed to beat the air more strongly than before. In no time at all, he found himself in a great garden abloom with flowers. Swimming towards him on the sparkling lake were three of the glorious swans the duckling had loved when they flew high above him.
I will fly to them, even though they beat me because I am so ugly. I'd rather be beaten by them than chased by children and scorned by dogs and go hungry all the winter.
Onto the water he flew and bent his head toward the birds. Then, what did he see reflected in the water? Not a duck, gray and ugly, but a swan. At that moment, a girl and boy ran into the garden.
There's a new swan.
It's the most beautiful of all. So young and so handsome.
They danced about on the shore while the other swans stroked him with their beaks. And the duckling that was no more shyly hid his head under his wings.
A swan, a swan, a swan am I. Whoever would have dreamed it? A prince among creatures beneath the sky. I'm almost ashamed, for so happy am I.
A beautiful, wonderful, delicate thing. No longer the ugly duckling.
The water shone clear and gay. The sun was warm and bright. He slowly raised his slender neck and spread his wings, so great, so white. And as he sailed into the day, the children marveled at the sight.
A beautiful one.